गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द क्लास फॉर 9th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस सब्जेक्ट. ओके, इन फिजिक्स आवर फर्स्ट लेसन इज मेजरमेंट. ओके, इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट द वेर्नियर कैलिपर. ओके, इन दट वेर्नियर कैलिपर वी आर सीइंग द लीस्ट काउंट, देन जीरो एरर, पॉजिटिव जीरो एरर एंड नेगेटिव जीरो एरर. ओके, सो टू कंटिन्यू दैट लेसन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द डिजिटल वेर्नियर कैलिपर. ओके, सो नाउ वी आर लिविंग इन योर डिजिटल वर्ल्ड. ओके, सो द डिजिटल वेर्नियर कैलिपर्स आर नाउ अवेलेबल इन sharp. Okay, so the digital vernier caliper, it has a digital display. Okay, digital vernier caliper will have a digital display on the slider. Okay, which calculates and displays the measured value on the slider. Okay, which calculates and displays the measured value that is on the slider. Okay, then digital vernier caliper, the user means ourselves. Okay, so the user need not calculate the least count, zero error, etc. Okay, so our next topic is what means screw gauge. Okay, so this is a screw gauge. Okay students, it's an instrument. So screw gauge is an instrument that can be measure the dimensions. Okay, it can be measure the dimensions up to 0.01 millimeter. Okay, so the least count of the screw gauge is what? 0.01 millimeter. Up to 0.01 millimeter dimensions, this can be calculated. Okay, the by using of the screw gauge, we have to find the dimensions up to 0.01 millimeter. Okay, so by using of the screw gauge, it is possible to measure the diameter. Okay, by using of the screw gauge, we can measure the diameter of a thin wire and the thickness of the thin metallic plates. Okay, we have to find the diameter of these both. Okay, thin wire and the thickness of the thin metallic plates. Okay, so next one is description of a screw gauge. Okay, so the screw gauge consists of a U-shaped metal frame. Okay, screw gauge consists of a U-shaped. So this is the U-shaped metal frame. Okay, U-shaped metal frame. So next, a hollow cylinder is attached. Okay, hollow cylinder is attached to the one end of the frame. Okay, so this is the U-shaped metal frame and this is the hollow cylinder. Okay, so this looks like a hollow cylinder. Okay, so this is attached to the one end of the frame. This is attached to the, these are the two ends. This hollow cylinder is attached to the one end of the frame. Okay students, so there is a two scales. So how many scales? There are two scales. Okay, one is known as a pitch scale and other one is the head scale. Okay, so first one is pitch scale. Okay, in the case of a pitch scale, it cannot be rotated. Okay, so it cannot be rotated means this is the pitch scale. Okay, there are two scales, no? So this one is the pitch scale and then this one is the head scale. The pitch scale cannot be moved or rotated. Okay, so it can be fixed. Here the readings which are graduated in millimeter. Okay, in the case of your pitch scale, the values are graduated in millimeter. Okay, whereas in the case of your head scale, it can be easily rotated. Okay, so this is not fixed one. Okay, it can be easily rotated. Here the sleeve means the readings. Okay, so the values are the readings which is divided into 100 divisions. Okay, starting from 0 up to 100 divisions, this is divided. Okay, so the readings are divided into 100 divisions in the case of a head scale. Okay students, one is how we are using the screw gauge. Okay, so first one is the principle of the screw gauge. In what principle the screw gauge is worked? Okay, so when a screw rotates in a nut, that is the rotating effect of a screw in a nut. Okay, based on this principle the screw gauge can be worked. Okay, here the distance moved by the tip of the screw, okay, the distance moved by the tip of the screw is directly proportional to the number of rotations in a screw. Okay, so that is directly proportional to the number of rotations. Okay, so next one is pitch of the screw. Pitch of the screw is nothing but the distance moved by the pitch. Okay, distance moved by the pitch means this one. Okay, so distance moved by the pitch, that is divided by the number of rotations in the head scale. Okay, number of rotations in the head scale means this one is the head scale. Okay, so here how many rotations can be done by the head scale. Okay, so that is known as pitch of the screw. So next one is least count of a screw gauge. Okay, so least count is equal to value of on smallest pitch scale reading. Okay, so pitch scale is nothing but this. Okay, so the value of pitch scale reading divided by the total number of head scale division. Okay, total number of head scale divisions means here there is 100 divisions in the head scale. No, so that divisions. Okay, so that is equal to 1 by 100 is equal to 0.01 millimeter. Okay, so the least count of a screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter. Okay, 0.01 millimeter. Next one is zero error of a screw gauge. Okay, whereas in the case of a vernier caliper, we saw zero error of a vernier caliper, then positive zero error, negative zero error. Okay, so like that, here also the zero error of a screw gauge is there. Okay, so this is what means if the zero of the head scale, okay, what is that zero of the head scale coincides, that means meet at a point. Okay, so the zero of the head scale coincides with the pitch scale. Okay, coincides with the pitch scale. Okay, so this one is the head scale, this one is the pitch scale. Okay, so if the zero of the head scale, that is coincidence with the pitch scale axis, means then there is no zero error. Okay, coincides means there is no zero error. Okay, next one is positive zero error. Positive zero error means if the zero of the head scale lies below the pitch scale, okay, lies below the pitch scale axis, means then the zero error is positive. Okay, head scale, if the zero of the head scale, this one is the head scale, this one is the pitch scale, so the zero of the head scale lies below the pitch scale axis, means then the error is positive. Okay, so the formula, we can, zero error is equal to n into least count, where n means head scale coincidence. Okay, head scale coincidence. Okay, for example, n is equal to 5 means zero error is equal to, we can put instead of n as 5 into the least count of the screw gauge is 0.01, so that is equal to 0.05 millimeter. Okay, so on the day I told, in the case of a vernier caliper, error is a positive, means then the zero correction is negative. Okay, so these two terms are opposite terms. Okay, so like that in the case of a screw gauge, zero error is plus 0.05 millimeter. Okay, then zero correction is -0.05 millimeter. Okay, then the negative zero error means if the zero of the head scale lies above the pitch scale axis. Okay, zero of the head scale lies above the pitch scale axis, means then the error is negative error. Okay, so that we can arrive the formula as zero error is equal to, because it's a negative error, so we can put the minus sign. Okay, so we can put the minus sign. The formula is 100 minus n into least count. Okay, because here the divisions in a scale is 100. Okay, so that we can put 100. So minus 100, here n is equal to 95. Okay, the coincidence is 95, means minus of 100 minus 95 into least count. Okay, so that is 0.01. So minus of 100 minus 95 is 5 into 0.01, so that is equal to -0.05 millimeter. So the zero error is negative here. Okay, the zero error is negative, so that the correction is positive, so plus 0.05 millimeter. Okay, students, understand? Thank you.